In this lesson, we will understand how to install the current Eclipse version on Windows 11. So let us start. Go to the web browser. On Google type Eclipse and press enter. The official website is visible, eclipse.org. Click on it. After clicking on the official website, the download button is visible on the right. Click on it. Now the download section is visible. Go below. Here the current version is visible. Click on it. And here two versions are visible. The first one is for Intel and AMD processors. So I am having an Intel processor. So I'll click here. If you want to check, go to start, type about and click open here. Here it's written the processor is Intel. Okay, so in this way you can also check. Now I'll click the first one. The mirrors are visible. Click here. The download started. Let's see. Here it is. Let's wait. We have downloaded the exe file. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The setup started. Different versions of Eclipse are visible. We want for Java, so I'll click here. Okay, for different versions you can check below. I want for Java, so I'll click here. After clicking, here it is automatically showing the current Java version. Therefore, you don't need to install Java separately. Okay, keep it as it is. And the following is the location where Eclipse will get installed. Okay. It will also create a start menu entry and a desktop shortcut. Keep it as it is and click install. Accept the terms. Click accept now. Now the installation started. Let's wait. We have installed Eclipse. Directly click launch here, or the desktop shortcut also created. You can also click here. I'll click launch. Now here you need to select the workspace. Workspace is a place where all your projects, plugins and files will get saved. This is the location. Keep it as it is. And you can also select this as the default. Click launch. Eclipse launched. Okay, so you can directly click here to create a new Java project, or you can close this and go to file. Click new. Here click Java project. Add the project name. Let's say I'll add Amit application. And here is the location of the project. I hope you remember our workspace location is the following. And I told you that our projects will get saved here. So the location is the following. Execution environment. It automatically took the current version 23. That's it. You can uncheck this. It is not required right now. Click next. Click finish. And here is your project. Now you can right click here and click new. And click class to create a new Java class. I'll name it demo, let's say. And here I'll select public static void name and uncheck this for a basic program. Okay. You can also add a package name. Let's say I'll add a package name com.studiopedia. You can add any name. Click finish. Now here is your first Java program. Let us print something. Here I'll write system.out.println to print a text. So whatever you'll add within this will get printed. Let's say I'll print my name. Okay. semicolon, and that's it. So this was the class file, and remember that the class file should be equivalent to the file name, else there will be an error. So this was your file name demo.java, also visible here, and the class name is also demo. Everything looks fine. Go to file, click save, right click, click run as, here select Java application. Now the output is visible, Amit Divan, and this is what we printed. I hope you remember the exact location of your project. Let's see. So it was in C drive, then users, HP, and here if you remember our workspace name was Eclipse workspace. Here it is. I'll click it and here is our project which we just created. Okay, source, and this was the com studiopedia package, and here is our file demo.java with the same code which we saw here. So for a free Java tutorial, refer the link in the description of this video. Thank you for watching.